You know what I mean?
Yo,
coming.
What up? Another episode of the Uncommon Bar Podcast coming right at you. Yo, fellas, we have three days before Christmas. Oh my God, the year's about to be over. Yo, but we're gonna end the year off right. We're gonna touch on some topics. One topic that we hit on before: opposite sex friendship. We gonna talk about, what song do you go to when you get in the mood? And there's a topic that there's a phrase that I heard, matter of fact, about 2 hours ago, that I want to bring it to y'all attention real quick before we really get started. I heard Steve Harvey say, all men can change, but there is only one woman we will change for. What do you feel about that? Yo.
Wait, one woman or one type of woman?
All women can change, but there is only one woman we will change for. What is that? What does that phrase mean to y'all? Because I mean,
it means he's selling more books. That's all. It's good for business. I love it. Love it.
What does that mean though, Steph? Who's that one woman?
I mean,
Harvey don't even know who that woman is.
Yeah.
I mean, he's been married before, so I guess she was the woman, and then she wasn't, and now she's the woman. So, this is his daughter playing it right, though. Got people selling, signing NDAs to mess with her. That's what's crazy.
I'm saying, all right, it is a phrase that was said, but what does that mean? Like, is it, can we, would men?
You can't change. You can't change for anybody. Because in the end of the day, you're gonna be, you are who you are, right? That's what Jay said. You were who you were before you got here, something like that. You can always, I tell my kids this all the time. You can lie, you can pretend, you can act like, you cannot run from you. You are always gonna show up no matter what happens in this life. You can only pretend for so long before you shows up. And then you're gonna have to deal with you. So you might as well deal with you now. I'm not changing for nobody. Ain't no woman out there that I'm changing for. I will change for the betterment of my relationship. I will change for my growth. I will change to make people around, like, I want to do things, but it's always going to be about me. It's not going to be for nobody.
I mean, I hear when you say it's going to be about you, you're not changing for no one, but like, we have three married men here. So what do you say about that topic, Gorgeous, when he just said that specific part? Do you have to change it at some point?
Yeah. But I mean, I think I said this before, like, I think when you meet the quote unquote right person, she gives you reason to want to change. So I don't think she's saying she's like, you better change. I don't think that it works. I just think you get with someone and based on her behavior, character, how she loves you, how she makes you feel, how she motivates you. There's things about yourself that she said, I'm gonna adjust these things to make the relationship better. So that's how I feel. Maybe that's what he meant.
I'll tell you one thing, shameless plug, but if I change for a woman, she's one sweet bitch. Oh yeah.
Woo! Because, what's up, man? What's your little take on it? I don't want to spend too much time on it, but I heard it.
Yeah.
Let me throw it in.
Yeah, I agree with what G-Gorgeous just said. It's pretty much, you know, you meet someone who's either up on your level or above your level, you want to level up yourself. And I think that's what it's about, you know. So, you know, if you meet the right woman that's on your level or even a level up, you in turn want to level up as a man. So I think it's just as simple as that.
Reggae Ring.
See, oh, shit. I didn't realize. Wrong meeting.
Wrong chat.
Reggae Wrong ring. Meeting, huh?
Reggae. Wow. Reggaeton.
Reggae wow. Ring.
I didn't realize that my shit is up there. Wrong.
Yeah, right. All right, so wait a minute. You R&B Ring, You reggae Reed.
Are you country? On another podcast, a Jamaican reggae Reed.
Are you country Reed? Pop Reed?
Kingston Reed.
I haven't met the country version yet,
Are you Pop Reed at any point?
We used to go to Jiggy Friday, so my old Zoom crew. I haven't been on this computer in like over a year, so that's crazy.
Port Maureen?
Back. Definitely not from Portmore, man. We rapping. I believe we should always want to change. You know, like there's negative things about it. We flawed, right? So we should always want to change. And I think that a wife just amplifies that, or a woman. They just do. Cause there's certain bad habits that we have, whether it's being stubborn, whether it's, you know, being judgmental, whatever the fuck it is, there's certain things about us that aren't good. And being with the right woman will make us want to change it. A regular chick would just, fuck it. You're going to be stuck in the same way that you are. But the right one is going to make you want to, you know, swallow your pride. The right woman is going to make you want to, you know, look at things differently so you can resolve certain problems. That's just it. That I believe those are the things. The key to a successful marriage is being able to reflect and understand the person that you're dealing with. So, yeah, mine definitely made me want to change. And I think the right woman will make you want to change. But I don't know about Steve Harvey with that one person, you know, because God forbid certain things happen in life, you know, breakups, death, all that. That means you'll never find another person to, you know, as far as companionship and match you, and you know, you want to give your all to. So it sucks. It's just, I don't believe what Steve Harvey's saying. He's an asshole, to be quite honest with you.
I think his intent, his intent was to say, you know, the right woman will make you change, but there's no like one person for one person and that's it, like in the world. So. Mm.
Mm. All right, so it brings me now to something I want to like, I guess, bring back up that we hit on, you know, about a year ago. But recently, Blair Underwood, him and his wife divorced after 27 years. And he ended up got engaged with a woman that he was friends with for 41 years. So it goes back to that question that we always go back to. Can opposite sex have a friendship that's just pure based on just friendship? There's no feelings or anything involved? Because the way I think about that is, man, so in 27 years of being married, right, you have a friend of 41 years. That means she must have, she was probably at the wedding, right? She was maybe at their home doing whatever, you know, having friends, hanging out, spades night, bingo night, whatever, right?
Yeah.
Like,
there's a lot going on.
So, wait, Picasso, wait. So my thing is like, were they scheming? Like, what was like, can men and women actually be like just
they've been friends, doing,
bro?
I just want to say I haven't heard much about the situation except for what you just said about that he, you know, she was his friend. But we don't know if like she was like a close like friend like that. At least I haven't heard that. Like you could have a girl you met from you went to school with in elementary school and like, oh yes, I knew her for 40 years. We friends. We go way back to elementary school. But that don't mean she was like around their relationship and being introduced as the friend and hanging over at the house like she was in the mix. We don't know that. And I'm not sure if that is actually accurate.
Okay. So then I'm gonna continue to ask you that question, Picasso. Can men and women be just friends? Like, you know, nothing going on. Does one generally have feelings for the other? Or just it's just, yo, I just see my homegirl as my boy, and the girl see the dude as one of her girls.
Does platonic friendships exist? Yes, they do. Can everyone have platonic friendships while in a relationship? Nah. Nah.
I mean, the older we get, right, we have to realize there's, I believe there's a chance that those, that they was platonic friends. Like, I don't deny that. But we're older now, right? So right. When the heart, when we open up our heart now, because when we're with someone, our heart is kind of closed off to a person. I'm not talking about our eyes and talking about the lusting after a person and what they look like. I'm speaking on the heart. When we open that up, because that situation doesn't exist anymore, like who's to say that you're not gonna really fall for someone that you're friends with? You know, because regardless of what, men and women can never be friends as men and men and women and women. That just doesn't, is not the same unless you're gay, right? And so if you're not gay, I can never have the same friendship with a woman that I have with my boy. It just won't happen. So to answer your question, MC, men and women can be friends, but there is a chance that, that there will be a moment if you and that person, you and the, to the Blair Underwood situation, if you and your significant other aren't together, there's a chance that you and your friend won't be platonic anymore. Y'all might be friends where y'all get together. And that's why, going back to our old show, you know, as a man, you know, you kind of skeptical about these things because friendships is one of the main things that maintains a relationship between a husband and wife. You know, you got to be friends for that relationship to grow and to sustain itself. So if you out here being friends with another man, you know, I'm not saying I'm jealous. I'm just a little bit skeptical. Like, hey, what kind of friends are y'all? You know what I mean? So I trust all you want, but nigga, like, feelings do develop after a while. So that's my take.
So Gorgeous, do you think there's a separation in terms of the feelings that of, like, if I introduce,
No, did you see, G just did a, he did a silent prayer while you were leading up to the question, because he know he got to tap dance well right now.
Why?
Gorgeous.
Why you got to tap dance for? Ain't no tap dance.
Gorgeous. I'll be asking you a question.
Got an extra bed in that basement, man?
I guess, let me say, Gorgeous, can men and women be friends, whereas there's nothing goes on, nothing could potentially happen between those two people. Like you're friends with your boy. That happened with a girl.
FCA shit, man. You're friends with a boy.
I'm gonna tell you what I think, right?
I hope so.
I think women and men.
That's kind of what I was going for.
1, 2, 3, 4, I think men and women can be friends platonically, if I pronounce that correctly. You know my shit. Anyway, I'm gonna give you what I think happened in these situations, right? I do think like men and women are friends over a period of time, right? Now, one person may go through something, and there's a period of comfort, right? Like I'm gonna lean on my friend to kind of get me through what I'm going through. And I think within that moment, something that was never there before gets developed in that time. And then it switches from platonic to something else in that moment.
So again, I go back to that question, like what switches? Because there's opportunity there now? What happened to the friendship?
But no, the friendship is, you got to understand something. Men are attracted to women. Women are attracted to men, right? While you guys are friends, you don't indulge in it. You don't pay attention to it. It's not something you feel or see at that moment. I just think it gets created in a time of despair or destitute, like what I'm saying to you.
Yeah, but you're bringing up a scenario of attraction because you can have a woman. Let's say a man is not attracted to that woman or vice versa. Would, like, what makes it cross over? Because two people are attracted to each other? What if one is not? What is one if attracted to the other, and one is
not? Always crossed over?
And there's no.
But it doesn't. It doesn't have to be attraction. I'm telling you, people so you get together. No,
I just repeated what you said.
Oh, no, I was just making a scenario, but maybe that's a, I mean, that's just one scenario I made, but I'm saying, you know, it could be various reasons that cause the lines to get crossed.
Do you think there's a moment where there's never a line crossed?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think you could be friends with the opposite sex comfortably for a very long time with no thought, no idea, no inkling, nothing.
Until something?
No, go
I'm saying, I think...
I'm gonna go over what attraction is, right? Like, let's not sugarcoat this shit. If the attraction ain't there, you can have a platonic female friend all day.
Right. Every
day.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly.
You're only friends with ugly chicks.
I don't use that word, but if the attraction ain't there, you're good. But if there's an attraction, you know.
You just waiting till for your moment.
You don't think you could have a platonic friendship with an attractive female?
I'm not saying I can't. I'm saying as far as it not crossing that line, if there's opportunity, as far as like us being single, nigga.
Wait a minute. Are we saying men and women cannot be friends?
No, you asked about crossing the line. I'm addressing the crossing the line. But if I'm in, I could be fucking friends with Beyonce. At the end of the day, I gotta respect my situation and want and be so involved with my situation that I don't want to cross the line.
Right. So you're not in a situation. Beyonce's your friend.
There's a chance I'm gonna take it down and.
Why? That's your friend.
It's an attraction, nigga. The fuck?
Because a friend is gonna be there for
what I'm saying. So many.
She's my friend. She's my friend in every situation, right? But guess what? Can we go into the locker room together, all of us in here?
What?
Can we all go into the locker room after the gym together, all of us in this?
Yes. Room? Yes. Right.
Yes. Yeah.
You can, and we still friends, right? I'm not even, I don't even want to look your direction.
Yes, absolutely. Right.
So now, could you go into the locker room if Beyonce was your best friend?
Oh, you can't. Yeah. Because you can't. Because
yes, you can.
Steph, what? And you just going to be like,
I'm just saying, you can't, girl. Because of the woman man thing. But my point is, woman man thing. But, and they have body parts that we can't see. What I'm saying is, why is it that men and women, attraction aside, can't be just friends?
They can't,
what would cause the line to be crossed. That's all I'm saying.
I don't think it's fair to say that in order for you to have a friendship with the opposite sex, that they may necessarily need to be ugly.
Yeah,
because that's kind of like what you're saying.
I definitely don't use the ugly word, so I ain't say it.
I mean, you say unattractive.
Attraction. I'm attracted to a certain type. That doesn't mean you ugly. I'm just not attracted to you. So I ain't using no ugly word up in here.
Oogly. Three O's.
So in our group chat, we talk about who you are more attracted to, Beyonce or Rihanna. Like, it's not
about... I can't go in the gym with Rihanna, but I can
it's
go
just
in
an attraction, gym. That's all. I ain't saying ugly.
So my man is gorgeous. You friends with Rihanna. You single, whatever. That's your friend.
I could be friends with Rihanna. I'm telling you.
And there would never be a point, right?
That ain't my friend.
Where you would cross the line.
No.
And you will feel free to hook up with a guy like me.
Word never. Not.
No. You
will feel free to hook her up with a guy like myself.
Oh, 100%.
Yes.
I can't understand what the issue is. That's guy code. Why would I not want to hook you up? Go with the never.
Yeah, like, only because you might have feelings for her because
we ain't talking about feelings over here, bro. We are talking about crossing the line.
Listen,
MC, I could be friends with attractive females and be fine.
This man,
exactly right,
and his wife divorced in May. He gets engaged a few months later and literally describes his new fiance as the most amazing, brilliant, beautiful, hilarious, thought-provoking, and insightful person he knows. Cause he been poking at. You kidding me? What was your wife then?
That might have been the case. We don't know that though, is all I'm saying.
I'm not uttering a sentence like that about my 41 year friendship.
But well, he's in a new stage. That's that new stage.
If the argument that we are making is not so much using that.
I'm gonna tell you that. Yes, men and women can be friends, but here's the caveat. Someone's attracted to somebody. I don't care who it is. Either you're attracted to her or she's attracted to you. That's all I'm saying. Now you can be friends all you want.
Trying to tell me you can't have a female friend that choose things. You say to yourself, my friend is beautiful, but y'all just friends and you be, that's it. You can't do that.
She don't think I'm the. I'm a dick in a glass jar.
Gorgeous. Gorgeous.
Dick in a glass jar. You put that thing open when you need it.
Well, it's shit,
come on, Burger King.
And I think I'm laughing because your beautiful hat. I'm gonna be honest with you. That's the only reason I'm laughing.
MC, let me ask you a question, right? You are 40 plus. At this stage in your life, you're not at a level of maturity where you could have a friendship with a beautiful woman.
See
and
how
be
you
okay.
changed it? Because that means at 20 he could have did it.
No, I'm
20. There's a lot of
when I'm 21. I wouldn't be talking like that.
There's a lot of lust and a lot of feelings.
Oh, so we can only be friends with women when we pass the age of 40.
But Stephen Cat, again, MC, at 40 plus, the level of maturity that you have right now, you can't have a friendship with a beautiful woman and it just be friendship.
100%.
Friends help friends.
I'm not 100% sure I could do that.
And it also depends on the man too. So it's like, you know, so it depends on the man too.
It all depends because you know what it is?
What if she's attracted to you?
Gorgeous, to answer your question, if we share things in common and we like to say that it's best to grow a friendship with someone, right? And then it formulates into something. If a friend of mine who I am attracted to is, you know, share my same sentiment, share my same feelings, share my same interest. Why wouldn't I try to pursue that? That was his example. That was really his question.
But that's the point. Like, I get what you guys are saying, but that's literally the point. You're single. You have someone that's a friend, but looks good to you. And you guys connect on this friendship level, and she's talking to you about her bad relationships, you're talking to her about your failed relationships, but you guys keep connecting. It's not about not being able to maintain a platonic friendship. It's about the fact that, like, yo, you guys are forming a bond that is growing to the next level. Like, there's a chance you could freaking like each other in a way that's not platonic. I just don't understand why this is so difficult. Like,
right. You can be attracted to somebody, you just never pull them. You just don't pull it. You don't pull it.
That's it. If Rihanna was my friend, there's going to be, and I'm single, there's going to be a night that I'm looking at Riri while she's doing the Dutchy wine and like,
tell him, Reggae Reem.
Like, what am I going to be like, girl, you know, you need to stop.
You my friend. We can't do this.
Stop, girl.
Stop it, girl. Like, cut it out, man. I get sounding good for the camera, but come on, man.
I can't do this.
Gorgeous. You disagree totally.
I think you guys are immature.
Great. Says the guy with the clown hat on, man. Like, are you kidding me, bro?
Why you think
Santa hat? Santa hat. We know what.
Why you think we're immature?
Because it's like you guys can't separate things. It's like one big blob. Everything is in the bowl.
Animalistic mentality.
Gorgeous. Do you understand? We all know you on this podcast.
No, don't listen to me. I'm gonna say this.
Say it.
Act like you know me.
I am 46. Right? MC, I'm gonna agree with you. At 25, I'd have been on the other side of the fence.
Damn.
Like, you even walk past me, and I think you find we on and popping.
So what makes that change? 46?
When you go through life and you develop a level of maturity and dealing with women over the years.
Gorgeous said, I think you guys
are much. I'm just being honest. Like I'm saying.
So you don't find women attractive at 46?
I didn't, you're not getting, you see, you're not listening to what I'm trying to say to you.
That's 46.
About. Go and try this again.
D, you was not including me in that immature
thing. No, you're not. The point I'm making is this.
You guys are weird.
We've been through enough things in life to the point where right now, the stage of life, we're supposed to be able to meet a woman that's beautiful.
You shouldn't be meeting a woman at your age.
Well, for whatever reason, you meet them through work or whatever.
Yeah, why can't you meet? You can't meet new people.
The point I'm making is this:
you can't meet new people.
You have a relationship.
That big boss man, Cassie. Don't tell me. Oh man, I met this woman today.
I did the other day.
Yeah, go you do it then, and bring.
I did the other day.
Bring her over.
And it's actually this is her juices that I'm drinking. She has a juice bar and all that.
You're drinking another woman's juice.
Yep.
This guy's nasty.
Gorgeous, finish your point, man.
Point, Mike.
No, he has a point. Go ahead.
What I'm saying is this. I a younger version of me would say, me and no beautiful woman can't be friends. I'm not gonna dispute that. What I'm saying is now the age and the stage of the life that I'm in, I'm not even talking about being married. I'm not even entering that into conversation. I'm just saying I'm at a point right now where I'm perfectly comfortable having a female that is beautiful as a friend, and that's it.
Without your wife?
Without my wife.
But you do realize that's not all we're saying. We're not saying that we're uncomfortable having a friend that's the opposite sex, that's beautiful. We're saying that we can't use the word never. You're using the word never.
No. I didn't
say it can never happen where you cross that line. That's all we're saying. We are all agreeing on having a friend of the opposite sex that looks good, but we can't say that because Blair, and we want to believe that Blair Underwood, right? Because that's the example. We want to believe that that brother was really committed to his wife and was loyal to his wife, and she was just a friend. And as the time went on, they broke up, and that friend became his girlfriend. Well, clearly his
fiance. I don't know what happened, but I'm gonna give a theory.
Yeah, we don't.
Right?
I don't know either. I'm just going off, but that's it.
There's a possibility that it started out where there were platonic friends. Like, no one was trying to do anything to anyone.
Right.
Over the years, he confided in her through various situations. Right? And then, like, again, she leaned a shoulder, he cried, that's fine. And this it creates a registry in your mind, right? She says the right things. She if maybe in this position, she wouldn't act like that. So you start creating a thing in the back of your head, you're taking record. Now, your current relationship, your marriage is going to hell. And again, she's there consoling you, giving you advice, all that good stuff. One thing leads to another, then you guys are now into something. So I'm not saying it's something that he planned out, like, this one won't do.
Right. It's the same thing when people fall for their therapist that they've been going to for years. That happens. When people who've been going to their therapist for years, whether it was marriage counseling, some type of counseling, and then you next thing you know, you see them, you know, being falling for them.
Getting cured.
A lot of relationship happens when you're vulnerable.
Yeah.
Yo, but you're only talking about him. What if she been plotting this whole time?
No, I'm not. That's a possibility too.
Was she really his friend then?
You never know.
What I'm saying is, let's say she was plotting.
Right.
Was she his friend?
No.
For 41 years, she just was not his friend.
Just waiting for her opportunity.
She was a sixth man off the bench like J.R. Smith.
Hello, Swish. I've been waiting for her to act up. Time to let her go.
Shout out, MC.
Uh-oh. We lie.
Swish.
Yo,
there's always somebody that has something for the person.
Whether bottom line, shout out to Deborah Cox and RL. We can't be friends.
You know I'm good. You know that's coming. Yo, what y'all drinking, man? Let's go around the room. I know
where my coquito at.
I know you're drinking that sweet B-I-T-C-H.
Sweet bitch.
Yo, Reem, drinking that Tito Puente today?
You know, Puente, but shout out to Sweet Bitch, man. He from uptown, Gun Hill, Tilden area. I'm glad to see that brother been lasting long with that Sweet Bitch wine, because it's a crazy name. I didn't think it was going to go that far, but it's making it.
Picasso, what you got drinking on? I know you, yo, Picasso, when you break in that little, like, Fugazi joint you on?
Man, I'm going strong, man. Shout out to the Wild Juice Bar sponsoring me for this little segment here. But now this is a it's called the Wild Refresher, pineapple, lemon, ginger, and cucumber.
We can't see the label, Kat. Let's see the label.
Yeah.
I still can't see it.
Cause I got the whole blur shit on.
Yeah.
But
we see it.
We got it. All right.
Scan that. QR code joint. All right. Anyway. So, this is a Wild Juice. I went to the store. I got a store right over on 233rd and Baychester. The Wild Juice. Right. And she got some good juices in there. I wound up buying a whole, like, detox joint in there, buying, like, 30 juices, supply me for the week.
You know,
and actually, two of them. I brought one for me and my wife. I brought my wife down and introduced her to her. Say, yo, babe, yo, come over here. Look, check these juices out. Young lady out here working hard, entrepreneur, got her store. We supported her black business. And we got like 60 juices a week each. Been on this little detox joint. It's pretty good. Feeling good.
Look at G face. He said, yo, babe, look, this is my new friend. G don't like that.
He gorgeous.
So you got money, bro.
That's not your friend.
Money, right?
That's not your friend.
Reem, did he say 60 juices?
That's 60 juices. I got enough money to go to the fruit stand and get some.
I was stuck on the 60 juices. I'm like,
juices. That's more than friendship. Broke.
A lot of money right there, champ.
I'm broke, baby.
All right, that, you can't go there with no.
That's the lead in.
I need to start putting out fires.
Gorgeous, what you sipping on?
I'm sipping on the coquito.
Woo-hoo. Finally, you got a man's drink.
Yo, Reem, I took it back. Remember this? We haven't had this in a minute.
Damn.
That's screw beasy for cheesy.
Yo, MC, owe me a bottle of Fireball. Yeah. I mean, that's screwball. You're not right.
100%. But yo, I want to shout out my man.
Give him some bird dog.
I want to shout out my man right here, 95 Killer Man. My man, X Grant. Glenn Graham. His brother's name is X, man. We just, he launched his 95 Killers. He's all on IG. And, you know, I went to high school with him, and he shout out to my man. Oh, look at that. My man always holding me down, supporting him for 20 plus years. I like to give my man Glenn a shout out. But yo, I want to transition to something real quick. And I know we all of us here are 40 plus. So y'all all know this. I got four songs. Y'all only got one that you want to set the mood right. So we got Whip Appeal, Babyface. We got I Give All My Love to You, Keith Sweat. We got My, Johnny Gill. And we got, I got to say it, we got to put this brother in. The Music, not the man. It Seems Like You're Ready by Kells. Where are you going to set the mood right? Whip Appeal.
Like you're ready.
Whip Appeal, I Give All My Love to You. My, Seems Like You're Ready.
Seems Like You're Ready.
Yeah.
Where are we going to set the mood? Steph, where are you
ready? Listen, I'm telling you right now, first of all, because you haven't even said what category this woman that we trying to bet that night.
Right.
I'll tell you why.
Yes.
I ain't putting no song on that got the word love in it with somebody that I'm just trying to, you know what I mean?
That's why I agree with Reem. Seems Like You're Ready.
Yeah, well, Seems Like You're Ready. I'll go with Whip Appeal. There's no love in that. What was the other one?
My. Johnny Gill.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you look good. Tonight, yeah. Keyword, tonight you look good. Tonight. One night. For so, one night.
So once again, bottom shelf, which song are you going to set the mood right?
You gotta go with Kells, man. Free to God.
Wait, hold on.
Free to God.
He says set the mood, not like in the, like you already in the jam, like the first no, one off the rip to no, set the
if
mood.
I'm setting the mood, I'm finna close the deal.
That nigga said temperatures rising.
Yo, Kaz, just
play all them songs in your head and you real quick, you pick which one you want.
Because what was the one with Love? Who sang that?
Keith?
Keith Sweat?
I'm gonna play that at my birthday party.
Yeah, I don't want to hear Keith Sweat when I'm in the bed.
I love you.
What? All this dude is does is wine.
I don't want to hear that. In the
bed. All he want to do is whine. He's whining.
Yeah, I'm not hearing that.
Girl, are you ready? Picasso, which one are you going with?
I think it's I'm conflicted between the two because, like I said, it depends on the type of woman you're dealing with. Is you dealing with for the night?
Bam.
Or is this like something like you know what I mean, a long-term type of thing? All
right. I'm gonna say it right now.
Since you brought that up,
it in and let's
taking it down, who you playing?
Oh, Kels.
You Kels. Formulating some type of love, who you going?
My. I'm what? Gonna play my.
Tonight.
Come back from a nice night out. Slip off your red dress. That's a seduction.
You play that, it's you gotta seducing. Let the tip. My man used to say, "Let the tip drip." You gonna leave that?
That is a like the art of seduction type of
plan
song.
Plan B, or you better get ready to be a daddy.
Or you better get ready to collect Social Security checks when she kicked the bucket, man. Because I'm telling you right now. Any woman
my mind
listen to bye.
play that joint. That's a tough joint.
Yo,
but here's the thing, right? I always want to ask this question too. Pretty brown eyes can only be played when you're with intimate black women. But only with a black woman. You can't play pretty brown eyes when you're intimate with anyone else in another race. I just wanted to say that.
That is false.
Oh yeah.
That is false. And I want to
I don't want to know how you know MC.
And I want to choose my song. Yo, I think for me, and I think I Kels is my guy, man. But yo, I think I'll rock with Johnny Gill on this one, bro. I think yes, I will sir.
Just
the way that song just comes in and the
right,
you know, like yo.
If right. I'm dating an older Jamaican woman, yes, because she'll love it. She probably what put down your rap, play the Sanchez version. I got it.
Back to you, bottom shelf. That song right there could be played for anybody, bro.
What my
brown no, eyes,
pretty brown eyes.
Gorgeous. Wait, Gorgeous said his already?
Yeah, Gorgeous said he's going with Kels for sure.
Kels is a winner, man.
So we got Kels as the winner. Yo, Picasso, man, get you one of these, bro.
What's that?
Get you one of these. It's a portable juicer. It's portable. You charge it up at night. You cut your three main ingredients and put a water. That should have saved you some. Y'all niggas is you rich, bro. Yo,
I got a
vitamin. This is support your friends. You gotta support your friends.
Yeah, I got a Vitamix. I mean, I could make juice all the time.
Hey, Cass, how much one of the bottles cost?
Greg bought that. Greg wanted to get them
for like $9.
$9. You got a discount for buying 60?
Hold up.
I really didn't want it because I wanted to support the business, so I just paid out.
I'm sorry, MC.
Hey, guys, the calculator on your phone work?
No.
Yeah. The calculator.
When you calculate 60 times 9, what your phone tell you?
I say
I'm gonna tell you, I paid $590.
As in
she had 590.
Yeah, because there was also these, there was
US dollars.
Yes. There was these daily vitamin shots.
We talk about this off the show.
Yo, listen, let me tell you something.
That's what we about, man.
Look, my mind is off the list.
Hold on. Let me just say something to the people. You could pay for health or you could pay for a copay. Either way, you go pay.
Yes. Don't tell the people bullshit. I'm not saying that you're not supposed to take care of your body. And I guarantee you, if you got your own fruits like Reem said and blend them suckers, it ain't gonna work out to 590.
I understand that, but we could say that about a lot of things. But the thing is, like I said, I'm getting it for the convenience. My wife could take 5 juices with her to work and be out throughout the day. She could have them. They fresh, they bottled up. And then also I could do the same thing. And also we supporting black business in turn too. So
I'm taking my off the list. I'm going with Kels. He says, I just want to look at you. Girl, you are so fine. I can't believe you're mine. And all I want to do, I want to make love to you. And tonight will be a special night of many more to come. And I'm so proud to be with you. So proud to share your love. And I'm done. I don't care. You call me scared of relationships or whatever. My is never getting played with somebody that I'm just trying to bet. I'm going with Kels. My man knows what to do, right? You know me, my body.
Nah, listen, seriously, the way Kel's really like broken down, like it seems like you're ready.
Right.
He's literally saying what we would want to say, but in a song, he's saying it.
And now, what we would want to do with a grown woman, just, you know.
Yeah, I'm about to say, because, you know, he was saying
that
Aaliyah
at 15. We just put it out there. What we would like to do with a grown woman.
That's my life. Yo, y'all realize that we spend money based on the amount of kids we have, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
because
right.
If Kaz had 4 kids, he ain't spending $590.
Nigga, he got 3.
One more. It takes one more for the fight. I spend that money.
Gorgeous. Just let it go, man. That man rich, man.
You have one kid, you get sweeping.
You get a sweeping.
What's wrong with his health, man?
Hey, Cass, what's the cutoff of applying to be a fireman?
That's amazing.
I'm done. This has nothing to do with that. You say
ADD, we are in the building.
29, I think. 29 is the cutoff.
And I'm not black. I'm OJ. Okay.
No, the wild juice on Instagram. Check them out.
Nah, but Kaz, you know what? I thought about it. You're correct. Because MC like spend that on a pair of sneakers. So you're right.
Everybody got their vices.
You're right, Kaz. You're right. I apologize, Kaz.
People buy Gucci sweaters that's like that.
And that's, you're right, Kaz. I apologize. You're right.
I like Gucci and I like help. And I got my motherfucking portable joint that come in a truck with me. You hear me?
I buy $29.99 sweater and juices. I'm good.
I'm not buying any more Nike. That's it,
nigga. Gorgeous. What do you spend money on?
No more Nikes. I'm not buying
what
no more.
What do you spend money on?
Kids.
Oh, it's blood clot.
Let's go back, man. We be nostalgic, man. I want to talk about pet peeves because I got a pet peeve that I want to talk about.
You want me to say mine?
Can I say mine first, please? Because I always get left off first.
Go ahead, MC.
You know what kills me, bro? Like, just the other day, like 2 days ago, I got a ticket because of that speeding thing for $50. They catch you with the camera, whatever. Where my daughter says, "You got another one?"
Oh, damn. Another one.
Bro. See, you got money. You just spending money on tickets.
Bro, why? Because I didn't drive 25 miles?
Yeah, because God did.
But my point is, that joint says it's not affecting your license. It's not doing, like, what's the purpose of that? I probably was driving on 30.
Free money.
You
got to be doing 35.
You got to be doing 35.
In a 20, but who drives 25 miles per hour?
I do
when I'm out of cameras.
Guys, you know,
I don't have that ticket.
Yo, I don't got that money, bro. As soon as I see that sign,
you have the ticket, nigga.
As soon as I see that sign, I'm slowing down.
I got the ticket. Okay, and you guys are in the 25 miles per hour, drive 25 miles per hour.
Every day, up and down Waychester.
Yeah, I got that money. 24/7.
Huh?
I keep my Waze on 24/7. If I'm in the car, the Waze is on.
So when the Waze is on, that's when
it tells you 25.
It tells you about the speed
camera. No, it tells you where the cameras are.
That's when you drive 24 miles per hour.
Yeah, whenever it tells me cameras coming down, slow down.
All right. What's your
problem? You want to...
Besides from Picasso spending $590, what's your pet peeve?
Mine's?
Yeah, yours. You know, that's another pet peeve of mine when people say mine's.
No, I didn't know if you said, I didn't know if you said my name.
Yeah, but
I say, I gorgeous, yes, you.
My pet peeve is.
You don't want to ask you, did your barber mess up again?
It looks so.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. You know what my issue is, honestly. I don't know if y'all get your hair cut by Spanish. Hold on, MC. Y'all get your hair cut by Spanish barbers?
Yes, I do.
Not anymore. I mess with a Jamaican now.
Yo, them Spanish barbers is forever drinking. They stay with a Corona.
So wait a minute.
She love him.
Your barber messed up your joint.
He took my thing down too low. My line down too low. And I don't like my line down. I like my line.
Because he was drinking.
Bro, there's two things that you guarantee happen is loud music and Corona. You're definitely gonna have that going.
So yeah, you gotta go to the Jamaican joint over here.
Yo, when you cut my hair and I have to tell you to bend down so I could you hear what I'm saying, you know the music's too loud.
Yeah, but why do you get in the chair when you know he's been drinking?
Because he drink all the time and he be nice.
MC is crazy.
You gotta go to the other spot with the Jamaicans, man.
Like, even when you're drunk, you can't mess up his cut. It's so
them Jamaicans ain't got a hot towel.
You drinking Julio?
It's a baldy. Do that drunk or hot?
Yo, wait, gorgeous. What's your pet peeve, bro?
Oh yes.
Yeah. Oh, I thought that was.
No.
You could cut his head drunk. It don't matter.
One of my pet peeves is I can't understand why dudes that's quote-unquote think that they're quote-unquote thug or street nigga, because they see you dressed up, they automatically think you're soft.
Mm. I believe that depends on them, the person. Some of them dudes is not stupid.
I like that one.
Think he's soft.
Okay. Reem, have you experienced that, Reem, or no?
I did.
I don't get that. Why? Because I have designer sneakers on and I got a suit on. I'm going to the car, so I'm automatically soft.
Yo. We really
that was the quick start, right?
Blog. So what was the designer sneakers you had on, Greg? Tell us. Just tell us.
See? People got money.
Tell us. He just told me. I spent money on sneakers. You just say he has designer sneakers and a suit.
I had a nice pair of trial fox. I had a trial fox on. Nice
trial fox. Okay.
Those are good shoes.
Yes, Raga.
Yeah. Reem, Reggae Reem. What's your pet peeve?
Bogle in the party.
It sucks, man, because I would usually have some good pet peeves when we not recorded. But one of my pet peeves are people that text and drive and hold up traffic.
Oh,
I don't like it.
Yeah, but you do that.
You don't know what I do.
You don't know me.
You don't know me.
I take that shit very serious. And plus,
you drive like this too, right?
I don't have to. I can text and drive. My car drives its fucking self. So I.
Hey.
Yo, MC. I'll see your designer sneakers. I'll raise you. My car drives itself.
No, because I don't pay for gas. Yo, real quick. I went because you know BJ's has free gas, right? So I'm on the line. I'm on the gas station line. And when I tell you the looks that I got on that line, they're like, yo, why is he here? And when I pulled up, it was my time to get to the gas pump. I drove by and went to the gas, to the fucking air joint. And they were looking like, this cheap motherfucker right here is waiting on this line for 15 minutes to get some free air.
Yo, you said BJ's got free gas?
No, free air. My bad.
Yo, so I was about to go.
I was like, what? I was like, wait, hold on.
I was about to say, I'm about to do BJ.
Yeah, for real. That allows me to buy more juices.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. I bet anybody $100 right now, though, we ain't going to see them juices no more. That brother Cass is going to the damn fruit stand next week. I'm going to show these niggas on fruit.
Yo, talk to me. My bottom shelf, man. What's your pet peeve, big dog?
Oh, my pet peeve is
not wearing hats.
Word, not wearing hats. Yo, black love. the term black love. I want to know, when did we decide that black love was outer-worldly experience that happens between only black people? Like, so I guess if you met your girl or your lady and she was Spanish or white or whatever, you met her in the sandbox and y'all been together 30 years strong, you, brother, you selling yourself short because you ain't have black love. Mm-hmm. So shame on you.
Picasso.
I want to know what makes black love so much better. I don't have a problem with it. I just want to know. Black love.
I think the same thing as Black Lives Matter.
Nah, the term is definitely overused, but I just think that black folks haven't loved on each other the way other people have. So now you have, you know, people overemphasize it, like black love. You know, there's a lot of things when you're in relationships with people who are not black, if you are a black man, that woman cannot understand.
Yeah.
Or can't see.
And I can't understand, you know, when I see him with a wife. So, like, I don't understand why we just can't love who the hell we want to love and just leave it at that. Like, when do we just start marketing ourselves as, like, our love is the love you need?
It's social media stuff, because if it wasn't for social media, you wouldn't have heard about it. This, you know, it's our generation right now, bro.
Because I want to know, if a white woman dates a black man, is she receiving black love? I just want to know.
You want that blood.
But you know, bottom shelf, this is a concept that I could never understand. It's like BET, right? I always, the black entertainment channel.
But oh, BET?
If there was ever a WET, it would be fun.
Everything else is WET.
No, it's not.
They call that the Spice Channel.
But why is it okay to be BET?
White entertainment.
Well, listen, I think we getting way over because I'm just saying. We're going to like understand the white supremacy.
Gorgeous is like, huh? Wait a minute.
Understanding this systematic white supremacy and this how we have been.
So let's go there. So
let me get my peeve in real quick. Hold on. So before we go there.
And let's go and address the black entertainment. Go for it.
My pet peeve is when people be on social media, whether it's Instagram or Facebook, and they act like, even family members, they act like they really rock with you more than they showing on social media. They be like, yes, my nephew. That's my nephew. I'll be like, yo, I ain't here for you like a year and a half, auntie. Like,
I see you, like, King. That's my brother.
Like, yeah, I see you. That's my cousin. I'm like, I don't even know where you live.
I wanna add to that. Because people be on the gram front.
And like they know you more than one.
And their captions be so extra. Oh, I love it. Oh, it makes me tingle inside.
Right.
I love this, my family.
Ugh. Right. I'd be like, are you looking at my
post the picture? Come on. Shut up.
Come on,
and gorgeous. I know you be looking through your fake Instagram page, because you be acting like you ain't on IG.
That damn first day of school, that shit hurts me, man. That first day of school. Lord. Because some of them kids, Lord, I'm gonna be quiet.
Like, yo, your kid ain't shit. Like, if you know he ain't gonna do nothing this school year, what's up?
I look at that bitch like, yeah, this is first and last day right here.
You feel me? He is like a fucking phone call.
No, listen, I'm an educator. I'm not going to let you guys speak that way. All right? It's the first day of school.
Yo, you know what, though? What's wrong?
Sneakers on.
Why? Why is there such a disparity? How come we got a million first day of school pictures, but there ain't a million last day of school? He finished. He did it. None of that. He's done.
You stop saying he. Because now you fucking... She, thank you.
You're right. She's finished. Where's the picture with the girl, the little girl with the book bag and like a stack full of work she did all year long? Where's that at? Where's that picture? Only do first day. We don't start. We just start. We don't finish. Okay.
You see? Yeah,
that's a pet peeve. That's a new pet peeve.
This is what happened.
Now you see why Gorgeous doesn't see you uplifting the kids.
This is why we get on tangent, man, because we end up talking about everything. But yo,
that's why they love us, MC. That's why they love us out here in these streets, MC. Oh,
but yo, it's about to be Christmas, fellas, man.
Doesn't it feel like Christmas? Doesn't it feel like Christmas?
Yo, well, we have another show, man. We just, yo, bro, you know how long we've been doing this, guys? Do you know how many shows we've done? Let me see who could guess that.
What's that one Christmas song you hate?
I'm aware. How many shows are on the site?
How many shows we have done?
68.
No, you're off.
12.
Now you're not even thinking.
Wait a minute. When we say how many shows we've done,
nigga don't know.
As a group.
How many shows we've done?
How many videos are on the site?
No, bro. Like, remember, we were filming before putting it out.
Oh, we definitely in the 70s.
No, you're close though. But yeah, we 81 shows we've done, yo.
I'm
gonna go.
Ooh, I was gonna say 78 too.
Nah, you wasn't gonna say that. Stop lying, man.
I was.
Oh, Picasso's like LeBron, bro.
Now he wants everybody to believe that
everybody like and subscribe, because when we get to 100, the show is over.
I had 78 in my fellas, head, man. But I was like, nah, that might be too much.
Yeah, 81, man. Yo, we trying to get to 100 shows, man.
Not all shows.
Yo, Merry Christmas, fellas.
Are you cutting this off, MC? You in a rush, man? Where you going?
Happy Kwanzaa.
Happy Kwanzaa, yeah.
That's a Christmas shirt you got on, black man.
That's right. Christmas missed us. Christmas missed us, man.
Yeah.
Wonder why Christmas missed us.
Christmas missed us?
Kwanzaa.
Wonder why Christmas missed us. Biggie, man. Come on, man.
I'm not black. I'm OJ. Get my joint.
Everybody get an African flag.
It's another Christmas holiday. It's a joyous thing. Let the angels sing, 'cause we're together. We got a thing. Hey, can't let it slip away. No, outside it's rain, it's lead when our bodies meet. I'll give. Come on.